The toll of COVID-19 has been focused on the nation's hotspots, from New York and New Jersey to Louisiana, Michigan, and California. But there are many counties and states across the rural West where case numbers are in the single digits with no deaths. Stephanie Tsai takes a look at the COVID divide.
Protests across America have pointed to a dilemma state officials have been grappling with since the coronavirus outbreak began. How much economic pain should business owners and employees endure to protect the public from COVID-19? In urban areas where people live and work in close contact, there's less debate. But across parts of the West, in towns of only a few thousand people, the question can be more complicated.
We're already so remote and rural that there wasn't a lot of risk here.
Jennifer Ramsey owns the Iron Bar, a gym in Pinedale, Wyoming. The surrounding county, called Sublette, has recorded one case of COVID-19 and no deaths.
People were doing their part with social distancing, and people wanted to open up. They wanted to work. They were worried about their livelihoods.
With that in mind, Ramsey defied the statewide order and reopened, only to be shut back down.
This business pays for everything, my mortgage, my utilities at home, and I ended up getting an eviction notice. I was pretty stressed out about all of that.
With lockdowns now relaxing in Wyoming, she was allowed to reopen in recent days with precautions in place. Across town, the Cowboy Bar is also open, partially. Owner Lila Golden also leases space to a barber shop and a restaurant in the building.
All three of us have suffered from it. I don't think Wyoming should have been shut down, let alone Sublette County.
She found a workaround to keep her business open, serving food and drinks outside. The county health officer said she was not violating the state's order.
He said he didn't have a problem with it, but we had to keep at least 6 feet social distance. As long as we did that, and a bartender brought the drink and another one took the money, then we could do this.
They found a little loophole.
Dr. Brendan Fitzsimmons is the health officer in Sublette County. His fear is overwhelming the region's healthcare facilities.
We don't have a hospital, and we're dependent on some of the surrounding hospitals to be able to take our patients. With the virus, you don't really know where you are today. You know where you are 2 weeks ago. If we had a cluster of cases here in this county right now, 30, 40 people who are very ill, it could be very difficult for us to deal with.
Sublette County Commissioner Chair Dr. David Burnett cautions that these towns are not bubbles.
Even though we are small, we're isolated and we're rural, we still have a lot of traffic through this area. We're impacted by seasonal workers. We have the oil field community that brings in people from the outside. We're on the map in terms of visitors wanting to come into our county.
Nearby in eastern Idaho, Rigby Mayor Jason Richardson argues the one-size-fits-all state order doesn't work.
We have some pretty clear data that in all of southeast Idaho, we haven't had any deaths. In our county, we've had 4 cases. We don't face the same thing they face over in Boise or in Blaine County. Here, where we don't have that community spread that you're seeing over there.
Richardson says the closure of non-essential businesses in Rigby, the principal town in the county, has devastated people's finances.
What I hear outside of the news are stories about families that aren't able to make their payments for their car insurance, their health insurance, their mortgages. Those difficulties pile up and they become just as dangerous and fearful as the pandemic itself.
I'm ready to open anytime.
From his empty Mexican restaurant near Idaho Falls, Juan Hernandez says he and his wife have lost 75% of their business and should be able to welcome customers now that they've taken necessary measures.
We can take tables out so we can separate it to show the people that they don't have to be close to each other. So we do a lot more cleaning. We use gloves, we use masks to show the people that we clean.
But some Idaho residents are unsure.
I'm cautious, but not paranoid. I think we're kind of doomed almost for a second go round if we open up and get too close too quick.
I don't know if I'd be comfortable because I'm kind of at a high risk, you know, with diabetes and a couple other autoimmune disorders.
In Montana, there have been no known COVID-19 cases in nearly half of the state's 56 counties. Officials say in part because Governor Steve Bullock started shutting down businesses a week after the first cases cropped up. With only a million people spread out across a state three times the size of New York, many residents outside the main cities are already pretty isolated.
Our curve, our projected surge, was effectively flat.
Dr. Mark Williams is chief physician officer for Bozeman Health and was involved in the state task force that evaluated stay-at-home directives and phased reopening.
When you look at eastern Montana, I think those counties have not seen a single case. So 2 or 3 weeks ago, when it became very obvious that the healthcare facilities in Montana would be able to maintain or be able to take care of a surge, then it became much more logical and reasonable to talk about reopening businesses in a phased fashion, especially in those areas which hadn't seen a single case.
Is there a warning that should go along with that as well?
We have to avoid that false sense of security. So in 1918, Montana was ravaged by the Spanish influenza. If we can reflect back on how other similar epidemics have affected rural communities, then the story or the risk can become very clear. Because in those rural communities, even if the likelihood of an outbreak is less, the access to healthcare resources is also less.
But Dr. Williams admits that while saving lives is paramount, for many, so is saving livelihoods.
Just recognize that when people are wanting to reopen their business, they're doing it for very good reasons. I think if we can all get on the same page and try to understand where we're each situated, those conversations become much easier. It's a matter of honesty and transparency.
Wisdom that could be applied across the country, divided by the pandemic. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Stephanie Tsai in Phoenix.